What is up, you guys? I hope you guys are doing great. This is not my real voice. So for today's video, originally I had planned something completely different, but the heavens, the Lords had another plan for me. Here we are. So this is something that I've been meaning to talk about for some time now, because I see that a lot of people have seen that I have been a part of two different beauty pageants, and I have never really shared my experiences, mainly because I was a child back then and I did not feel comfortable talking about things that were actually so major. But now that I am completely out of that circle and I have an audience that might find this helpful, I think it's almost like my duty to tell you guys things that I have seen and gone through being part of beauty pageants in India. So let me just start off by saying this. I did my share of research on YouTube and I wanted to see if there were other people that felt like me. Surprise, surprise, there are a lot of people that felt like me, but not a lot of people have gone into detail. No one really explains what it really is like to be on the other side, where you are a participant in a beauty pageant. So I think it's time for me to spill some tea. And honestly, I think sharing my experience might just prove really, really valuable to someone out there. I had two completely polar opposite experiences, which is why I think I am the best person to talk about beauty pageants and experiences. I participated in Spavik Miss Beautiful You in 2017, I think. The second beauty pageant that I did was Mr. and Miss Asia. It was hosted by Elite. Alright, so backstory. I have been really into everything about modeling, from runway to prints to pageants, every single thing. And when I was in college, I just knew that I had to explore every single thing and experience every single thing by myself and then decide what I wanted to do. So that is how I ended up participating in Spavik. So the selection process was, Spavik is a Japanese, I think, skincare company. They came to our college campus and they were scouting for girls. I filled up a form, I gave them a few pictures, we had like a sort of a personal interview, and I got in. And then there were about 30 to 45 girls from all over Delhi who were selected, and we were all called in for a 2-day grooming course, which was so helpful. It was so good. The coaches, the trainers there were so polite, they were so kind. I think that was mainly because we were all from Delhi University. Aditi Govritrikar, I am so sorry if I'm butchering her name, I love her, she is so beautiful, it's unreal. She was the judge, and when I heard that, I lost my shit. This was held in some auditorium, I don't remember which one, my memory is pretty bad, but I remember the experiences clearly. Almost every pageant has 3 rounds, and Spavik had that too. Round 1 was introduction, round 2 was runway, round 3 was question answer with the selected girls. Everything went very smoothly. I was very confident. It was such a great experience, and I won. I think that was the first time that I felt like I did something big when it comes to modeling. I think it was almost like my first break. It was a huge deal for me. My mom, dad were super happy. I also got like a decent amount of money. Of course, 30% tax cut ke, but it was great for a third year student. And I just thought, this is how every beauty pageant works. This is great. People are there to teach you stuff and groom you, and it's just so good for your confidence and for your self-esteem. That is what I thought. Boy, was I wrong. So the next year, there was this makeup artist that I worked with on a completely different, unrelated shoot, and she really liked me. Like, you really click with the person, and she did. So this pageant comes up and she texts me and she gives me all the details and then tells me that Ranvijay Singh, Prince Narula and all these MD people are judging the final round, and she thinks I'll be a great fit for it, And then she tells me that I'll have to pay some sort of a registration and grooming fees, for which I will be staying for about 3 days in Hilton Janakpuri for my grooming and personality development classes. And I thought it sounded great, but I did not really need that much grooming because I was already working as a model by then. So I told her that if I have to pay some sort of money, I don't think this is something that I want to do. And then she pulled some strings with the organizers and stuff. She sent in my profile and I got in for free. I told her I would do it, and I think that was a huge mistake. I had such a bad time there. The moment that I reached there, there are a lot of girls and I click with some of them instantly. We start talking and we just get along so well. But there are these two girls. I don't exactly remember where these girls were from, but I'm guessing Himachal, Uttarakhand, somewhere around that. Hated me the moment that they saw me. I don't know why. And then the organizer, who was also the main person and also the queen bee of that entire establishment, I think her name was Sonali, Sonal, something like that. She walks in and she asked us all to give our introductions along with our achievements. Just go up on the center stage and I introduce myself. I tell them my name, my height, my vitals, my hobbies. And then they ask me, aren't you the one who won a beauty pageant? Then why are you here again? And I'm like, someone called me here. There was this very weird thing there where the girls and the boys were not allowed to talk to each other, because of which there was a lot of weird energy in the room. While the girls were practicing, the boys kept talking about us, and when the boys were practicing, the girls used to keep talking about them. I don't understand how 20-21 year olds are not able to communicate with the opposite gender. We were three girls sharing one room, so I am crossing my fingers sitting there that give me any one of these 18 girls. But she sticks me with the two girls, the only two girls that don't like me. I just really wanted to pull my hair out, gathered all my senses back, and I told myself that I cannot get distracted. This is the place that is going to teach me a lot. It did teach me a lot. It taught me that people are fucking weird. Day two, we all go down to practice our runway walks. The trainers there are some people from Splitsvilla or Rhodes. They are there to groom us. They are there to tell us what is wrong with our personality and how to hold ourselves up. I don't want to sound arrogant, but those people were not really qualified to teach anyone anything moderately related to modeling. I said what I said. The coaches were terrible. They did not know shit. Not like I'm perfect. Of course I wasn't. I still am not. But they were just so bad. They used to talk to us like kids, like school kids. Even though they were not that old themselves, I think they were like, what, 25, 26? But they used to talk to us like kids. Hey, idhara, hey, aise chal. And I don't really like people talking to me like that. Like, especially if it's in a professional setting, I don't expect people to talk to me like that. The entire environment was so toxic. Another thing, the people that run these pageants hate you if you have a speck of confidence, a tiny atom of self-respect or confidence, or if you have done anything in your life, they are going to hate you. They need people who are extremely new, who can be molded according to them. And me, I had such a bad time every single hour that I was there. We were sleeping at 2, waking up at 4. It was so terrible, and people were smoking, people were drinking, and it was just not professional at all. There was such stupid prizes. Best silky hair, best long hair, best clothes, best nails, best ass, I don't know. I did not get anything, and I was so heartbroken. But I was like, fuck it, at least I'm getting out of here tonight. And then they announced second runner-up, first runner-up, and I'm thinking, how did I not win anything? Like, come on. People literally, I think, won like best phone cover, best pillow cover. I don't even remember. I was so devastated that how could I not even win one single title? One. Just, you could have given me one. And then all of a sudden I hear people screaming my name. The audience is screaming my name, and I'm like, Rhea who? And then they announce the winner, and I was the winner. Even if I had won and gotten away with the cash prize and everything, I would have told the story exactly like it is. This is what happened with me. But here's the final twist. They promised me, I have a picture of me and Ranvijay Singh and my father and a ton of other people holding a check of 70,000, I think it was 70,000 rupees, which was promised to me since I was the winner. I never hear from them again. Never. The main person, she called me once. She told me that they are under some sort of a debt and they could not make enough revenue off of the contest, and she would pay me. They basically conned everyone, every single participant that paid money to be there, the participants that didn't pay anything but won, and that money was rightfully mine, but I never heard from them again. I tried calling their numbers and it was just a huge mess. My dad wanted to make a legal case against them, but I just thought it would be a lot of trouble for nothing. Even deleted their Facebook page after a few months, which was so shady. So this is how Mr. and Miss Asia Elite conned me of 70,000 rupees that was mine. I am glad I got out of that entire situation safe and unharmed. That place was so toxic, so terrible. If a person or an agent or a company reaches out to you and they want you to participate in a beauty pageant and they ask you to pay money for it in the name of grooming fees, it is a huge red flag. There is nothing that you need to pay for. It's all a scam. I really hope that if any of you in the future, if any of you guys participate in any such event, make sure that you do your research, you know what the company is, and you know that they have done events like this in the past. Talk to people that were a part of the event in the past and ask them about their experience. This was my take on beauty pageants in India. To shorten everything up, beauty pageants are a scam. They scammed me of 70,000 rupees that I was promised. I did not learn shit, and everyone just hated me for having a personality. Let me know if you guys have any similar experiences in similar workplaces. I would love to know, because I don't think this is normal, but I don't really know. So you guys tell me, and I'll see you guys on Wednesday. I'll see you guys the next time. I have to stop saying the days because just... And yeah, I'm done. Take care of yourself. I love you guys. Like, share, subscribe, do your thing. And I'll see you guys in the next video.